when I was making this video, I was trying to find other people who agreed with me on the internet. And I think it's safe to say I'm probably the only one who's going to stand out on a limb and say, I loved Halo 4. I think it was the best story. And out of all the Halo games I have played, it is my favorite. Halo 3, very close second. But Halo 4 to me was just so, so good. And I think a lot of people don't like Halo 4 because it was such a radical change from what we knew. I think a lot of people were really frustrated with the story. You know, the Prometheans themselves, it was a new enemy to fight. The Didact fight wasn't really that great. And if you're a super fan of Halo, like I am, and you've read all the comics and you've read all of the other media, you know that that wasn't even the end of the Didact, which makes it even worse. Like, it was really, the game in of itself didn't really do a lot other than open the door to a new enemy race, and then we didn't really see much of a resolution on it. So I can understand that. But in fairness, it did take Halo 3 iterations to beat the Covenant, and we're still fighting them now. So I'm not really sure that that's such a hard criticism. I appreciate that 343 really went out on a limb to give us something new. New enemies, new vehicles, new weapons, new locations. It was a major overhaul for the series graphically. By and large, the audio, to me, unprecedented. I love the audio in this game. The sound effects are so phenomenal, so visceral. Even the Spartan boost that you get, even the way that the ragdoll physics work when you die, your Spartans have so much more heft and feel to them in this game than any other game. And I love that. They did such a good job of making you feel like a real armored soldier, not just a normal walking person who was wearing armor, but you almost felt, I don't want to say over encumbered by it, but there was a heft to this game that has not been felt in Halo 5 Guardians or in any other Halo game outside of this. And I really did appreciate that. Additionally, we got a really interesting storyline, at least with John's loss of Cortana and him going through really mourning, which we've never seen really from a Spartan. You know, Spartans are meant to be these tough, rugged robot people who feel nothing and would cut their own arm off if it, you know, if it was required of them without, you know, any reservation. And unlike, you know, a lot of the stuff you read about in the books, this was really the first glimpse I think a lot of people saw into some of the mindset of a Spartan. And we saw John really suffering and dealing with loss and, you know, probably some depression, honestly. Very interesting space for him to be in, you know, the master soldier that he is, you know, basically, you know, dejected and beat down at the end of Halo 4, talking with the captain, you know, expressing his feelings, you know, about, you know, I don't have time to have feelings. I'm a soldier. And Lasky telling him, you know, you can be both. You can be both a soldier and a person. Very, very powerful stuff. But I guess I was the only one that liked it because, like I said, looking online to try to find something to other people positive to say about Halo was incredibly difficult. Specifically to the multiplayer, I know there was a lot of complaints regarding, you know, borrowing from other more popular franchises. There's a lot of comparisons between this and Call of Duty, and particularly with the pseudo kill streaks that you get when you get enough points, you can call in an armament that'll give you a saw or a plasma grenade or something like that. I think people felt that that was a little too close to Call of Duty. You also had a kind of weird scoring system, which unfortunately, and I say unfortunately because I did actually like it, was abandoned. You wasn't just a point for a kill, but you started to get things like headshot bonuses and close call bonuses and stuff that you would normally get as like a medal, which you may or may not have cared about before. Now front and center, actually a point value associated to them. And some of the game modes were associated more with those point values than just with traditional Slayer of going to kill, you know, a certain amount of enemies. There was also some really interesting objectives modes that were put into this game, you know, fortifying base stations that would spawn vehicles and getting in different kind of drops and building, you know, static sentry turrets and stuff. A lot of people also felt that it was not really traditional to Halo per se. And I liked it. I thought it fit very, very well. I thought 343 came out swinging really hard. And I really am curious to wonder, you know, what reality people did like this game. How much more refined in this design, the sound effects, the heft of your Spartan, the story that went behind John's loss. I wonder how much more of that we would have seen. You know, unfortunately, I think there was a major course correction at the end of Halo 4. And when Halo 5 Guardians came out, I think it was very different than what a lot of people wanted it to be and expected it to be. And it really did abandon a lot of these great design ideas that 343 had refined. Particularly the sound effects were all kind of reverted back to the original Halo sound effects. And, you know, while the Prometheans obviously still play a very large part in the game, you know, the idea of the didact and a lot of that was kind of just, it faded out. And that was unfortunate. But, I'm one person, I guess popular opinion is going to dictate it. And if sales were poor, which I don't know how easily it is to find that kind of data, you know, maybe it would dictate people didn't like this game. And maybe that's why. Although I think Halo 5 is significantly worse story-wise out of all of them, out of all the Halo games. I think Halo 5's story is really, really bad. Definitely does not withstand the test of time. The sheer amount of fights you have against the Warden Eternal, playing with Spartans that weren't John, getting introduced to a new group of Spartans that nobody really wanted. I think that's really where a lot of the, you know, 343 kind of fell apart more so than this. But I thought it was only fitting since I've been playing so much of it and having an absolute blast and enjoying it and enjoying what they tried to do with this game, enjoying those hit markers. Finally, we got hit markers in Halo. Enjoying the kill streaks, having fun, you know, getting a saw on demand, getting a railgun on demand, playing some of those more objective-based gameplay, particularly in competitive mode. The 6v6 stuff is just really, really fun to play. So I wanted to throw this out there and say, you know what? I think I like this game. No, I don't think I like this game. I know I like this game, and I think you should give it another chance. You know, Master Chief, the joy of Master Chief Collection is it's just a check mark away from being deleted from your life forever or getting back into it. And I guess I implore you to hit that check next time you're looking for a public match and give it a whirl. With that, I am going to prepare myself for the inevitable flood of comments about how bad this video is and how bad Halo 4 was. But I am ready. My flame shield is prepared. And I hope you guys found this video informative, or at least makes you think about Halo 4 in a different light. And if I could reach one of you guys, it was absolutely worth it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Take care of yourselves. And until next time, I will see you guys on the other side.